Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What's happening, everybody? I'm Gerald Undone, and they hate us because they ain't us. So, I'm doing today's video a bit backwards. Normally, at this point, I already have the script written and everything done, but today, you're coming along with me for the testing. So, here's the situation. I have my computer. This is a continuation from the previous computer build video that I did from editing PC. And I've had, that was using the B550 Master motherboard, and it's been great, but I've had a couple issues so far, which I think are motherboard related because I've swapped out a lot of other hardware. One has been this terrible audio interference that I've been getting through my audio interface. And I think I mentioned at the end of my last video, I had the solution where I used this Defender thing that kind of removes ground loops from USB ports, and it solved the problem, but I never actually figured out what the root cause of the problem was and fixed it. And the other one has, some of my USB ports have been, they've been having instability. If I plug certain devices into certain USB ports based on certain controllers, I'll get blue screens, but not in other ones. So I'm thinking that maybe the motherboard might be problematic with the USB ports, but luckily the folks over at Gigabyte AORUS are all about this nerdy testing, and they sent over three more motherboards here for me to swap out to see if we could narrow down what the issue was, whether my board was just a lemon, or if there's something wrong with that specific B550 master that you should be aware of. So that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna unbox these, look at the motherboards, swap them out for the one that I have, and see if we can figure out what was causing the problem. I'm gonna grab my computer. I'll also show you the ground issue that I'm having, because it's also kind of peculiar. I've got my multimeter out, and then we're gonna swap out the motherboards and see if we can narrow it down. So let me just unbox these, and then we'll get to it. B550 Vision D. An X570 AORUS Master, so we can make sure it's not related to the chipset. And another B550 AORUS Master, just like the one that's in my computer currently, so that we can rule out whether my motherboard is a lemon or whether it's all the B550 Masters. Okay, so one of the things that I wanted to show you was this grounding problem. So I'm not an electrical engineer or anything, so some of the stuff I say might be a little bit maybe not precise, but just I'm going to share what I've tested. So the reason why I noticed this is a problem, other than the fact that the audio was obvious when not using this ground loop isolator thing, it just sounded much different. It was like high-pitched whine. And then if you ran anything that was demanding on the system, it would make a lot of noise. So I noticed that, but then on the Discord, they recommended that I started checking. On the Discord, they started recommending that I checked some of the grounding points to see if there was continuity, to see if maybe that's what was causing it. And I did that on both this computer and my previous rig, and the previous rig had no issues. Now, let me show you. So, got my old multimeter here, and if I set it for giving me an audible beep for continuity, then anytime that there's continuity, it should make that sound. So if I touch one probe to one of these screws on the power supply, which should be grounded, and then touch another one of the probes somewhere else, and I think my arm's gonna be terribly clipped here, I apologize for that, but that's just what's gonna happen. If I touch, say, the back plate to the GPU here, then you can hear it. And if I touch, you know, inside of a USB port, just like, not like inside, but the I/O shield around the motherboard or the antennas, basically just any of the ports that are attached to the motherboard, we get continuity. But what's strange is that if I turn the computer on, it goes away, where on my other computer, it doesn't. So for instance, if I turn this on, okay, so it's booting up now. I'll do the exact same thing, plug it in here, and then as you can see, or as you can hear rather, it's not beeping anymore anywhere. And the same thing happens if you touch one of the standoff screws on the motherboard or basically anything that's sort of safe to touch internally, it's the same thing. When the computer's off, you'll get a continuity beep, but when it's on, you won't. And so what I think might be happening is that I think the motherboard might be grounding differently when it's on versus when it's off and using a different path. Because my understanding of how a ground loop works is that whenever two devices are grounding through a different route or path, that you can get a ground loop, which is why generally you want to have, you know, all your devices connected through the same, you know, powered bar or something into the same outlet. And this seems to solve it because what this does is that it gives a separate power source. So you plug this into the USB, then you plug your audio interface there, and there's a separate USB cord that goes in and you can plug it into the same power bar as your computer, and then that solves the whole ground loop problem. But why is there a ground loop in the first place on this machine versus the other one? And like I said, I've tried swapping out a lot of stuff and disconnecting things and disconnecting all the peripherals, and nothing really helped. So now we're gonna first what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna take the motherboard out and run it just outside of the machine to see if there's some kind of issue between it and the case, or something's being kind of like shorted. And if that doesn't solve it, then we're gonna switch out the motherboard. Okay, so I've got the original B550 masterboard that was in the computer here, sitting here, and I think I've got everything connected that I need. I've got my CPU and 24-pin power connectors, and I've got the connectors here, because I don't think that I can, for the front port, because I don't think I can turn on this motherboard from the motherboard. I think I need to use the front port of the computer, so I've got that connected. I don't have the graphics card connected, but I already tested it removed when it was all together and it didn't make a difference. Let's power this, or let's check it first with it off and see if there's any differences for continuity, because now we can even probe the motherboard. And we're getting the same results that we got inside the case. Now I'm gonna power this on and hopefully something bad doesn't happen. So it's interesting, I'm getting continuity on some USB ports and not other ones, but why don't I get it when it was all assembled? It's frustrating when stuff like this happens, when you get intermittent problems. Okay, update. This is the new B550 Master, and unfortunately it has exactly the same problems. There's no ground continuity when the computer is running. I still get the audio interference. I took it over to where I normally have it and checked it with the same audio interface, same problems. If it's both boards, I'm just gonna assume that it's all the B550 Masters that have this problem. So then we're gonna have to switch to another motherboard. And I was thinking the X570, but maybe we should try the B550 Vision D first, because if it doesn't have problems, then that solves that it's not B550 in general, it's just this particular one, or maybe a couple of the B550s. And if neither of those work, then we'll go to the X570 and see where we are from there. All right, so I'm gonna switch out this motherboard for the B550 Vision D, but let's just take a look at it first, because I haven't actually seen this board yet. Okay, so this is the B550 Vision D, which, although it looks good to my eyes, is definitely a tough thing to expose for. This is so white, it's like probably beyond 90% reflectance. You could use it to set your zebras off of. But it looks nice. We've got a very similar configuration to the B550 Master, which you can probably see in there. The only difference is we'll just check and see what the setup is regarding the PCI Express and the USB. All right, so based on what I'm seeing in the manual here, there's a lot of similarities, but there are a couple differences that I think could be benefits in some regards, and then maybe a couple of drawbacks. One, there's still no USB-C front header, which kind of bugs me a little bit because this case does have a front header. I think only the X570 has that. But in terms of other inputs and outputs, the main thing with 550 is all about the PCI Express, how it's not fully 4.0, but there's some 4.0. This top PCI Express slot is a 4.0 16X, just like it is on the 550 Master. But then this one below is a 4.0 8X, and you can run both of them bifurcated to 8X each because they share bandwidth, which I don't think is the case on the 550 Master. Could be mistaken though. And then this top NVMe is, again, PCI Express 4.0. So that part's the same as the 550 Master. It's like these top two are 4.0 and then it goes down to 3.0 because this one's a 3.0. And then this one is, that's the difference here, is this is 4.0, where this bottom one is a 3.0 PCI Express slot. But you're only getting two NVMEs here because this bottom one is populated by what looks like a Wi-Fi card, and the cords run up here, and then I guess you would hook the Wi-Fi antenna up. So you only have two NVMEs on this one, but you can bifurcate your PCI Express 4.0 GPUs or whatever if you wanted to. So let's go ahead and build the computer back up into this. I don't know if there's gonna be much in the way of driver changes. I think a lot of this stuff is the same. There might be a couple Realtek becomes Intel things, but we'll take a look at it. And let's go from there. Okay. Go ahead and forget pretty much everything I've said up to this point. Okay, well not really, but there have been some developments. I've rebuilt this computer a total of 6 times, I think, so far over the weekend, and I was able to figure out all the problems because, yes, it's more than one, there's 3, which is why it was so difficult to diagnose. So my original mistake was thinking that all of these issues were related to the ground loop. They're not. And thanks to AORUS for sending over all these extra motherboards, I now have duplicates of everything, so I was able to narrow down exactly what the issue was. So for issue number 4, that whole thing with my USB ports causing blue screens, it's unrelated to these other problems. And it turns out that actually was just a bad motherboard. And that was the other B550 Master. Because this B550 Master, as well as the other two boards here, the B550 Vision D and the X570 Master, none of those three have the problem that that other motherboard did. So I'm just going to go ahead and assume that that was just, I just got unlucky and then that one was faulty. So that's solved. That's unrelated. It's kind of a red herring in the diagnosis here, though. For issue number one, regarding the continuity, for this one, I think it's actually a case issue. I think it's this R6 case from Fractal Design, because what I did is I swapped out all of the guts of this thing, including the power supply, all of the hardware, into the other computer that I keep referring to, which is in its own NZXT case. So basically, I swapped all the internals, and the continuity issue followed the case, not the internals. So once all of this stuff was put in that NZXT case, I did have continuity, whether on or off. But when all that stuff was put in this case, I went back to not having continuity. And I also tried a few other things to see if I could fix the case. I replaced the screws, the standoffs for the motherboard. I even chipped away some paint in certain areas to try to make sure that the contact was great. Nothing seems to have helped. So I don't know if this case is just insulated differently than the other one that I've used. But what's weird is the fact that I do get continuity when it's off, but not when it's on. And this is something I'm hoping that maybe you guys, if you have, you know, an electrical background or whatever, maybe you could explain this in the comments to me. Maybe just a resistance thing, like the case has high resistance, and when you power it on, the load makes the resistance too high to get continuity. I'm not really sure, but why would a case not give you continuity from, say, the motherboard to the power supply when it's on, but it will when it's off? I'd love to know that answer. But anyway, I narrowed it down that it's the case and not the motherboard that's causing that grounding issue. Then for issues 2 and 3, this is where it gets strange. So I thought, okay, now I've got a setup that doesn't have that grounding problem. I've got all these guts put in that other case. I have continuity. So let's fire it up and see if we hear the sounds. And I did. Again, I got that high-pitched ringing right away. So I was not expecting that. But I figured now that I have a test configuration that is a few steps forward from where we were before, when there's like four problems and I don't know, I don't realize that they're all separate problems. Now I started swapping parts out again, piece by piece, to see if we can narrow it down. And I did. It was the RAM, the same RAM that you can see here. It's this AORUS RGB memory. The stuff that I originally installed when I did this build the first time. As soon as I swapped that part out for just some cheap non-RGB DDR4 slow memory that I had, the ringing stopped. But I don't really understand why the memory would cause that ringing sound, unless it has something to do with the RGB. Maybe the controller for the RGB, the dimming of the light, has like a frequency of switching, and that switching frequency is what we hear as the ringing sound. I don't know, but if I don't put the RGB memory in this motherboard, the ringing goes away. So that's issue number two, except for when I put the GPU under load, which was issue number three. That sound does come back, but it's a lot quieter on the other computer that has, when you have continuity, it's a lot quieter. So I do think it's aggravated by the whole grounding issue, but also that weird interference sound can be heard when the panel is off. And it was easier for me to tell this in the other case, because the other case is not like a soundproof case like the R6 is. And so it turns out, I think it's actually just coil whine coming from the GPU, because if you get your ear right up to it, you can hear it from the GPU. And I think because of the grounding issue, but that sound gets through and then goes into my speakers, where they don't when I was using this USB Defender thing, which is interesting, because why would this USB Defender, which is supposed to be a ground loop isolator, make it so I couldn't hear the coil whine unless the coil whine was being aggravated by the ground loop? Does that make sense? I believe now that I could definitely configure a build that wouldn't have these problems. I could do a different case, I could do a less coil whiny GPU, and I could use different RAM, and I think I wouldn't hear anything, even if some of the problems persisted. Maybe even if there was still a grounding issue, I might not hear it, even though, like I said, another case might not have the grounding issue. But that also kind of speaks to this little USB Defender thing. This is not a sponsored video. I have no reason to promote these. I just took a flyer on this. Someone on the Discord was like, you should try one of these. So I bought it. They're expensive though. They were like 70 or 80 bucks for just this little USB stick. But it actually solved all the problems. So I guess to wrap up, since Gigabyte was nice enough to send me all these extra motherboards just to test the issue that I was having, I should probably say some nice things about the motherboards to thank them. So in this one, I've got the X570, and I think that's the one that I'm going to keep in there, and I'll explain why in a second. But if I had to rank these based on, because I did get to build them pretty much back to back, I was able to kind of, I guess, experience them all, and I would probably rank them in order of price. So the B550 Vision D is the cheapest one at $259. I like this one. I thought it had a decent building experience. This would be the one that I would probably recommend if you needed to go dual GPUs and didn't need too many M.2s. Like maybe you just had one NVMe drive and you wanted to do dual GPUs on the B550. This is probably the way to go. Next up, I guess my second favorite, if you will, of the three would be the B550 Master, which was my original pick in the original build that I did. So this one is just a little bit more. It's $269, so $10 more than that. And it's pretty similar experience, to be honest. The only thing I would say that this one's probably better if you want one GPU and more NVMe drives. Go with that. That one's more if you want two GPUs and fewer NVMe drives. And it has more like standard input outputs than the Vision D, but fewer of maybe the more specialty ones. Like it only has one USB-C port and only one RJ45 Ethernet port, but more just standard USB ports. But it does have more SATA connectors if that's something that's important to you. One thing that the B550 Master doesn't have that I wish it did is there's no CMOS clear button or really any kind of like buttons on the motherboard itself or even on the back panel. So if you want to clear your BIOS, for instance, you have to actually jump two pins, which is kind of inconvenient. Which brings me to the X570, which is probably my favorite board, unfortunately, because it's the most expensive. Now, this is revision 1.2 and it costs $329. But it solves a bunch of the, I guess, limitations that I found with the other boards when building them. It's basically no compromises when it comes to the whole GPU NVMe choice thing. Not only are they all PCI Express 4.0, where on here only certain slots are, but you can use them all and you're not really giving anything up. I guess the trade-off there would be that it's actively cooled, so the chipset actually has a fan on it. But you only really hear it when you first boot up. It ramps up, it's loud, it's whiny, and then it goes away right away before you even like get into your operating system. And because this case is sort of like a soundproof case, it's a really nice fit for this because I don't hear it at all when the case is put together. Which I also think this better complements the R6 case because this is the only one of the three motherboards that has that USB-C front header, so I can actually finally use the USB-C port on this case, which is why I think I'll probably leave this one in the computer. Also, when I was doing the tests on the bench, it also proved to be more useful because it does have power and reset buttons right on the motherboard, as well as on the back, it has that clear CMOS button to make that easy to manage your BIOS, as well as an easy way to flash them. And there's two BIOSes, so you're gonna have some redundancy there. But what I can say though, after having built all of these back to back, is that the experience was pretty much the same once we do get into that BIOS. So the setup was the same, like all the things are in the same order. It's really, really easy to find. My overclock was maintained on all three boards with no issues. Each one could support it. And it's pretty, like it's not crazy. It's like 4.35 gigahertz on the 3900X. So I mean, there was no issues on any of these boards doing that. And when you actually get into Windows, there was no driver issues. So I guess the devices are all close enough that it's very seamless where there was no like driver conflicts at all between the three boards. So that's great as well. And now that I know that I don't have a motherboard problem with any of these boards, I'm happy to use any of these in my current rig. So thanks again to Gigabyte AORUS for sending these over so I could test this. There's definitely some relief involved in finally, I guess, knowing what was going on, even though it's multiple culprits. Like it's so much easier for just one thing. Like, oh, you didn't flick the switch. And now it's fine. And I also want to thank you guys for coming along with me on this ride. I know this is kind of a crazy video, but do let me know in the comments if you have any theories about any of these issues that we've discussed along the way. But that's going to be it for me. I hope you found this video entertaining, or at least helpful. And if you did, make sure to leave the old thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. But if you did not find this video helpful or entertaining, try setting the playback speed to 75%. Yeah, all right. I'm done.